Swami, and we say happy abundant year 2018. We love you so much.
It's a year of abundance, it's a year of pleasure. We're expecting God to perform many things that you are expecting. Great way.
Yeah, we are expecting it indeed. So today we are continuing with our program. We believe that you are excited as much as we are excited.
it's a topic other people there. Especially young people,
they are curious.
They wanna know more. Yeah. Feed us. You see.
They say curiosity killed the cat, but curiosity is a good thing to have.
It's something that keeps you going.
Yeah.
If you're curious, if you're not curious,
yeah,
you won't go anywhere. You will sleep like.
Ask questions.
Exactly. You'll find answers.
Yeah. So last week we talked about Adam and Eve. Adam being an original version,
mm-hmm.
and Eve being a revised version,
mm-hmm.
and we also highlighted that Eve was made to be able to have a bigger capacity so that she would be able to effectively help Adam,
mm-hmm.
and we also talked about selfishness,
mm-hmm.
The fact that you need to die and then live for one another.
Mm-hmm.
So now let's make this more practical. Because I realize that people love to be given examples so that they'll be able to understand what you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to give you a story.
Okay.
A real life story. Maybe it's an example, but I'm not going to disclose much.
Okay.
Here is a man married like us, a man of God, but he does not want to allow his wife to flourish. But he can be able to empower other people, but he cannot empower, he's like oppressing his wife, saying, no, you're not allowed.
Hmm.
What causes that?
You see, I'm laughing because what causes this is insecurity.
Mm-hmm. Who's insecure then?
Here is the husband.
Mm-hmm.
When a husband is insecure, you see, you share the glory with your wife.
Mm.
Okay, if I say you share the glory, like for example, if I am healthy, if we as the church, we are healthy, who gets the glory? Jesus.
Yeah.
If we are prosperous, who gets the glory?
Jesus.
His kingdom expands, invades territories which are known. At this moment, there are many poor people in the church.
Mm.
Jesus doesn't get the much glory that he deserves.
Yeah.
Exactly. So if I don't empower you, I know when I give you something small. Let me make an example. When I take my seed, my spermata, and give it to you.
Give you babies.
You will give me babies. Mm. You see? And whatever, if I share with you my ideas, my vision, you will expand it. You will come with many ways of many ways of expanding my vision. It's not because you are going to overtake me and take my vision and be yours, because I am yours and you are mine. You see, insecurity destroys you because you are, it's a selfishness. That means I'm scared of you because I'm able to empower other people. Why don't I empower you?
But does it look like that?
It doesn't, because we are turning a blind eye. We don't want to be real in it. If I empower you, if you become better, that means my children are going to become better because you are the greatest teacher in teaching my children, our children. You see, even when I'm giving something to you, you are the greatest teacher. You are a mother even to the church. I'm the father, I'm the man. What I do, I can do as much as the man. But if you give it to, they said, if you teach a man, you teach an individual. But if you teach a woman, you teach the whole community, the community or the nation at large. You see, when I'm afraid of my wife, I don't want much glory. I need to have, if I want to expand my glory, you see, Jesus took only 3 years on earth and he left the glory to his wife. What happened? The wife has expanded from Jerusalem in the Middle East to Judea, to Samaria, into the outskirts of the world. Who expanded his glory of his husband? It's a wife. It's exactly your wife, my wife. He's doing much greater things. He's in, she's influencer child in every spaces of life. You see, when a man is not empowering his wife, you must know that there is insecurity.
So where do they begin? Because we have seen, I believe as a church we need to speak the truth and address the things that are happening, especially in the church, you see. So the insecure men that are there, maybe it's because they've been raised without fathers, they don't know their position. Where do they begin?
You see, insecurities, as you have said, insecurities is coming from reality, some things that happened in the past. You can't be insecure if you haven't encountered things. There was no father in your life, there was no father in your spiritual life, and you grew headless, like a headless chicken, moving around, you're hitting yourself, solving your problems in a way that seems to is right. You see, you saw your different role models. You don't know what is really right because you don't grow up in a good environment. You see, you need to come up into reality and see that, hey, I've got a problem here. So I need a spiritual father. I need a guide. I need a guidance also. What I see, I need to verify with somebody, especially like a man. You will see other men who are intimidated, who have insecurities. They don't want to have a spiritual father. You see, they jump from this. They've got television, spiritual father. They've got books, spiritual father. They've got DVD, spiritual fathers. You see, you need to have a real father. When your wife, you have a misunderstanding, where your wife can contact your spiritual father. You can speak to your spiritual father, so that your spiritual father can speak to you. You need somebody tangible, somebody who is reachable, you see, so that you can take responsibility. If I didn't do well, I will not wait or write even things which are not right. So if she can stand up and say, I will call daddy, I will call your father and tell him what you have done. So if you don't have a parent, you speak to the parents. You need to come up and be real in this thing and say, I've got a problem. If I've got a problem, I must have a way to deal with the problem. Face the reality and face those things.
Okay, now let's swap, because I believe marriage is built by two people. So now here is a wife. She has been edified, made, and she's turned to a crown. Now she's shining. She can do everything. What can you say to a wife who has been empowered like that by the husband? Where, how does she, with all the abilities, how does she submit?
No, I'm
I
laughing.
know why you are laughing. Okay, let's continue.
She said she'll put me on the
I
spot.
did, and I'm actually putting him on the spot, yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
It's so hot.
I know. That would be the odds.
I'm not burying my head into the sand. Okay, this is what's supposed to be done on that.
Okay.
Okay, what is supposed to be done? You need, when things are happen like that, you need to understand each other and be patient because, in situation like that, thing that may happen is to force one another. Because sometimes when you another partner, you have empowered your wife, you wanted to her to be strong, you wanted her to shine, but she shines more than you. She has a strong personality. What is needed there? The wife to understand that, okay, I'm shining brighter than my husband. My husband maybe is intimidated, or if he's not intimidated, but other people, they look like that. You see, so it thinks you need to work because it's something that has been done throughout years. It's not something that has been done overnight. It's not an overnight thing. You need to understand one another. Remember what I said. I said a woman has been given an ability more than a man. You see, a man is, and when you come in an angle unexpectedly from a man can easily shut down. Some they say he can go to the cave. So when he's on the when he is gone to the cave, don't follow him to the cave. You need to give him some time until he realizes, no, it won't help me to stay here in the cave. Let me go back and face the reality and work things out. When you force him, when you force a man to make decision in that moment in time, the decision you won't like. Sometimes when he keeps quiet, he doesn't want to hurt you, he doesn't want to give you a mind that is not sober. He wants to be sober. Give him that time until he's sober and say, no, I figured out something. Let's work it like this. But when you pressure him, we as men, we cannot think sober when we are cornered. We need our space. Sometimes when we are cornered, we go to our cave and we hide ourselves there like Elijah did. So when we after we are sober, then we come out. Nobody can call us to come out of the cave. We voluntarily come out of the cave. Then when we come out, we face the reality and we continue with life.
So in summary, what you're saying, if the wife has been edified, has been made to shine, but you also need to, the wife needs to know her position and also be patient when a balance is being created. Now the man needs to be secured, knowing that when the wife shines, the glory comes to him. Okay, so I think we understand that. It's amazing. it's a wonderful subject. I know we are laughing and we but many marriages are being broken when it comes to that, especially in churches. You know, when the pastor, a wife is capable, and you find the man of God pushing and pressing down the wife because he doesn't know how to handle her if she shines. So it's up to us as pastor's wife to just humble ourselves, at the same time making known that it's our husbands who shine. Even though sometimes it's not that easy, sometimes it's difficult to bring that balance.
But when you work together, you need to understand one. That's why I said in the beginning, you need, in the previous program, you need to understand each other. You are you have an assignment of your partner. When you have an assignment of your pastor, your partner, then that's where you can figure out. When things go wrong, you know how to fix that.
Maybe let's talk about this, because we are pastors. I'm a pastor's wife, and it's like we are husband and wife also. And then sometimes when you are a pastor and you are pastor's wife, people think things just happen. You have the ability to do all things. But I just want us to address this because we've already started this topic. Here is a man of God empowering everybody in the church, but cannot empower the wife. Where can he begin? Because maybe he has this insecurities. I know you've spoken about, but how can he start helping the wife who thinks he has been rejected for so long?
Okay, if I can start, maybe like saying, like we are in the province of KZN, KwaZulu-Natal,
yeah,
where even on the posters you see the man, the man is in front,
yeah,
there is no wife behind, and when you see, when you come to the church, there is only one seat in the front, it's the seat of a pastor. You see, other people, they don't see any problem with that,
yeah,
but psychologically we see that the man is leading this church. But when you come to another church, you see a husband and a wife in the same picture.
Yeah.
Also, that means these people are family people.
Yes.
They're very family.
Mm.
Not saying those who appear as men alone, they are not valuing families, but they value family. But psychologically, they are telling you, as you come in here, the one leader is the father. The person who is leading, who has a vision, is the father. Then when you see psychologically, also when you see a father and a mother, the picture of a father and a mother, or the husband and a wife, the pastor and the pastoress, so you understand altogether, oh, I've come to the family church.
Yeah.
You see, psychologically, then you will see that as you continue with the church, who is leading here? You see, that's how it is. When you are hungry for power, you make sure you shine. But when you are a leader, you influence people.
Yes.
You see, there's something different between a boss and a leader. So a boss wants to be known that he's the boss in the house or in the family or in the church. But when you are a leader, you want to shine, you empower your people so that you can grow up together.
There was one man who said, my wife is my crown. But at the end of the day, you find them divorced. What happened there?
You see, when it's like that, I can take you and marry to you because you are beautiful. You are slim. My purpose is not for you. You are not. I'm not taking you as my wife, as my partner. But I'm taking you as somebody when I go out.
Show off.
I show off through you. You see, they are different. Maybe sometimes we need to speak about the reasons why people they get married. You see, there are different reasons. When we grow up, Tina, in our times, when somebody wants to get married, you have to take a doctor, you have to take a nurse, you have to take a teacher, a wife must be like that, so that when a ministry doesn't go well, your wife will support you. You see, you wouldn't take just an ordinary Christian. She must be beautiful, she must be working, some of those type that I've mentioned. So if it's not that type, then you wouldn't marry. She must be beautiful, she must have all those things. So you wouldn't take anybody.
So
because
the motive is wrong.
The motive is wrong. That's why other marriages have started very wrongly from the beginning. That's why we are having all these problems. You don't marry somebody because you love that person. You don't think that you can grow with that person. You can empower that person. As you grow up, there are things that you discover together.
Yes.
Because you see, there are so many things that can change when you grow up. That's why others, they say, you've gained weight now, you need to reduce eating, you reduce your weight, because he wanted you in the beginning. He wanted you to be a clown, to show off when he goes to meetings, to go to conferences, to go to some places. So he wants to show off through you. But when you lose that, then get affected easily. Then you can easily divorce because of your thing. Then other things, they creep in because there's something that have happened that have offended the man or the woman. Then they get separated because the main reason that who was attracted on is bastard.
Is it true that people can say, I no longer love you?
They can, but they don't mean it.
What does that mean?
I mean, that's why even before people get divorced, there is this time that is called separation.
Yeah.
So when you separate, people who were in love, they will miss each other. So that separation, that defining moment, how much do you love that person when you are separated?
Mm-hmm.
Then you'll find that when you are separated, there is a string that can connect you. You want to see him.
Mm-hmm.
But I fight with him, but you want, because there is this thing inside.
Mm-hmm.
That means we need to deal with our mind in order to resolve what we feel inside.
Yeah.
We can feel love for you,
mm-hmm.
but our mind is not connected.
You
because
have
love,
precious.
But love, it's not only, I say, love is not only in the heart, but the love is in the mind.
Mm. Yeah, this is another topic altogether. No, we've run out of time.
Oh my
it's
God.
Amazing. It's amazing. We are enjoying this topic. I really love speaking to my husband because when I speak to him, I get all these like juicy stuff and cream of the crop. And I hope that you're also like finding the same. So we have to close. We would like to ask Dr. Swane to close in prayer. And we just want to say we love you, viewers, and we pray for your marriages. May the marriage flourish and shine.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, I pray for viewers right now.
Amen.
Father, I pray that you lighten the eyes of their heart so that they can see the purpose for marriage. And to some that married for wrong reason, Father.
Mm.
Today they are changing their mind, they are repenting, Father. I pray that your grace will come and cover them and help them and empower them, Father God, to be able to accept what is freely given to them. In the name of Jesus, I speak for the restoration of marriages and openness of the mind and healing the wounds of the past so that they can be able to see the future together. Father God, we bless you, we worship you in the name of Jesus for the healing, for the restoration of the marriages in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. See you next time, same place. Shalom.
Shalom. Nothing missing, nothing broken.
Amen.